Hey guys, so today I'm going to be showing you a fall look. I tried to stick to as many drugstore products as I possibly could, but then again I am working with what I have since I am on a makeup no buy. But this is just going to be mainly how I got my eyes, my highlights, and also my lips, because I decided to do something a little bit more bold. It's fall time, so let's bring out those voluminous, seductive, vampire-y lips. I don't even know what I'm trying to say. I just wanted to do this move, I guess. I don't even know. But anyway, so I am really eager for you guys to see this look, so make sure you guys just continue to watch to see how I got it. And of course, I hope you guys enjoy it.
So nothing has changed. I'm going to start off by priming my eyes with the MAC Paint Pot in Patchouli. Using the Maybelline Eye Studios Quad and Coral Laces, I'm going to take that copper orange color and a MAC 217 brush and focus it on the center of my lid and sweep it outward to the outer corners. Now using that champagne-y pinkish type color and the same brush, the 217 brush, I'm going to focus that color on the inner corner of my lids and sweep it inwards to the copper tone. Now using that chocolate brown tone and a Makeup Geeks pointed crease brush, I'm going to sweep that inward to my eyelids and then focus it on my crease. Just going to use a fluffy brush and blend all of those together so there aren't any harsh lines. Taking that same fluffy brush and going to the Naked Basic palette using the color Faint, I'm going to focus that color right on my crease and all the way up to my brow bone just so that it can further diffuse that chocolate brown tone that I used. Now for my highlight, I'm going to use the color Venus from the Naked Basics palette. I'm going to place that on my brow bone as well as my tear ducts. Moving like the speed of sound. Feet can keep on the ground. And now of course I'm going to blend that all together with a fluffy brush. Steering away from my eyes for just a minute, I'm going to focus on highlighting my face with the Maybelline Angel Winder as well as the Maybelline highlighter. They're both in honey. I'm going to place that underneath my eyes, down the bridge of my nose, my Cupid's bow, and also the bottom of my chin. Moving like the speed of sound. We can keep on the ground. With my infamous beauty blender, I'm just going to blend that all out, but I'm not going to set it because I want to give my face more of like a dewy type look. Keep moving like a bullet train. Like a bullet train. Like a bullet train. With my NYX Curve eyeliner, I'm just going to create a winged eyeliner effect, a little bit more dramatic than I usually do it, just so that it can elongate my eyes and bring a little bit more attention to them. Very quickly, I'm just going to line my waterline with the L'Oreal Smoldering Eye Kohl. Like a Going back to the Coral Oasis palette and using a pencil brush, I'm just going to focus that on the outer corner of my lower lash line. Using that same brush and going into that palette once more, I'm going to take that lime greenish yellow color and focus it on the inner part of my lower lash line, just to add a little to my eyes. Using a fluffy brush once more, I'm just going to blend that all together so there aren't any harsh lines. I did lose some of my highlights, so I'm just going back in and touching that up a little bit. Now it's time to add some depth to the face, and I'm going to use my CoverGirl Ebony Bronzer, and I'm first going to take my Real Techniques contouring brush and just contour my face, and then I'm going to take my MAC 224 brush and contour my nose. Favorite is blush right now, like of all time, and I know favorite isn't a word, but just go with it. I'm going to take MAC Lovejoy, and with a Sigma blush brush, I'm just going to pop that right on the apples of my cheeks and blend it up towards my hairline. Using MAC Mineralize Skin Finish and Soft Gentle, I'm just going to highlight my face. And I use a beauty blender because I feel like it gives more of a natural highlight. Of course, you already know we gotta blend that right on out so there aren't any harsh lines. I'm pretty sure you guys think that I forgot to do my mascara routine, but no, a girl will never forget her mascara. So of course you want to make sure you load up those lashes. Now it is time for our lips, and first I'm going to take Night Moth, which is a lip liner by MAC, and I'm going to line my lips. Next I'm going to take Milani Sangria, which is a beautiful cranberry lipstick. I am in love with it, and I'm just going to fill in my lips. To finish it all off, I'm going to set my face with MAC Fix Puffs. And that completes this fall makeup tutorial. I hope you guys enjoyed this warm eyes and vampy lips look. And if you want any more fall themed videos, make sure you thumbs up, as well as subscribe, which is located right underneath. I love you guys so much, and I will be talking to you very, very soon in my next video.